Now children, let us begin to read our stories, okay? Today we are going to read the first story, okay? Time to read. No problem is too big. Amarnath was in class 8 in the school in which he had been a student since junior kindergarten. He always looked at life casually. His common remark was, "I'm cool." But now in 8th class, things didn't really turn out to be cool for Amarnath. He was faced with problems of one kind or the other. If he scored 70% in maths in one term examination, his mark sheet did not show any improvement in the next. On contrary, he went down drastically in the subject but topped the class in history paper. Now here children, it is said that there is a boy called Amarnath, and in which class he is? He is in class 8 and he is studying in that school since junior kindergarten, means junior KG, okay? And he is always cool and he thinks that he is a cool person, okay? Now, but in class 8, the things had really turned out. But now in class 8, the things didn't really turn out. He had faced with problems of one kind or the other. Like now he is facing problems in the maths examinations. He is scoring 70% in one term but did not show any improvement in the next terms. Okay. But he went down in other subjects but always topped in which paper? History paper. Okay. And Amarnath would dawdle while the teacher called out the attendance and would suddenly wake up with a start when his friend sitting next to him nudged him hard. Well, his teacher would then make a snide remark, "Amarnath, listen for heaven's sake." The teacher would yell in frustration, but nothing changed. Amarnath's lethargic disposition to hard work. Amarnath had two passions in life, relishing all the tasty items available in the fast food joints and devouring books other than his textbooks. Now here children, in the class also, whenever the teacher used to call attendance, he did not pay attention. He was rather made attentive by his friends or by teacher, and they used to say him, "Amarnath, listen for heaven's sake," the teacher would say. Dada. The teacher would say Amarnath that, "Listen for heaven's sake." And Amarnath had only two passions in his life, that is, he used to like tasty items in the fast foods and devouring books other than his textbooks. Okay. His mother would plead with him, "You are so good with your memory on anything you read. Why don't you read your textbooks also? That way you would score marks like laddus, wouldn't have to face your father's temper." Amarnath would just smile. His sister Darshini was a delicate student. Amarnath was always compared with her in academic achievements. He would always turn around to remark whenever she boosted, "Let's see how we both make it when we leave school." with all the seesawing in his academic performance through school, Amarnath was ready to enter the university for higher studies. "I'll take up medicine," he said very decisively, "because I'll be relating to people every day and not to machines." "What medicine? With your marks, how will you fare in the competitive examinations with the casual way you prepare for any competition?" "Be sure, son, I will not, because I cannot pay any capitation fee to get you in." "Better be serious," declared the worried father. Now here, children, his family members are worried about him. Now even his mother is saying him that you should work with your memory so that you can score good in your examinations and don't have to face his father's temper. And even his sister was compared with him according to the academic achievements, and they used to compete with each other to see how much they score when they were in the school for examinations. And Amarnath was ready to enter the university for higher studies, and he wanted to take up medicines after he completes his 12th examination. Means he wanted to become a doctor, okay? And even his father was worried about his marks because he was not studying well at that time. Okay, and his father is advising him that he must prepare for the competitive examination so well. Okay, and he is saying to him that he will not pay any donation fees if he requires. Okay, now let's read further, children. "No longer a child now, grown into an adult at 18 years of age, Amarnath began to see problems looming before him. His head whirled as he thought of rigorous coaching classes, the money that his father would have to spend to get him enrolled into any of them. The regimented work schedule of taking tests every day, competing neck to neck for every mark with the fellow students in the coaching class, all new faces for him. Life was indeed getting tough day by day. The art master in his school, Mr. Girish, was a good friend of Amarnath. That was because he always explained to Amarnath how every problem had its own solution. He explained to Amarnath that the problem had been looked squarely into its face, and when it was analyzed threadbare, it would turn out that the problem wasn't really there. Mr. Girish always simplified things for Amarnath. Now here, children, Amarnath is now of 18 years. Now he has began to face problems with the rigorous coaching, even with the money the father would have to spend for him for his education, and even for competing neck to neck for the marks with his fellow students in the coaching class. And life for him has indeed become a tough day by day, but he had a good friend, his art master in his school, Mr. Girish. Okay, and he goes to Mr. Girish, okay, to discuss about his problems. And Mr. Girish explains Amarna that the problem had to be looked squarely into its faces. Okay. Mr. Girish used to always simplify things for Amarnath. Now let's read further, children. And so Amarnath went to meet Mr. Girish one week. "So what is it now?" asked Mr. Girish when he saw Amarnath at its door. "I want to become a doctor, but I find tough to take coaching and tests," answered Amarnath, crestfallen. "Well," smiled Mr. Girish, "your problem is simple and can be resolved easily. Come, let's sit down and work it out. What are your strong points? Write them down according to how each one matters to you." Amarnath wrote them down one by one. Memory to recall came first, able to draw, sketch and design came next, looking at the joy of learning, not just the textual contents, followed, and Amarnath paused. Now here, children, one evening Amarnath goes to meet Mr. Girish, okay, and there also Mr. Girish says that I will resolve your problem easily, okay. And Mr. Girish tells Amarnath to write down what are your strong points. Then Amarnath writes down them one by one. Okay, so what are the strong points he had written? The first one he writes is the memory to recall. Then next one he writes is able to draw, sketch and design. And even the third one he is writing that he had a joy of learning. Okay, and there Amarnath stops. Okay, then let's see what happened next. Okay, "I can't think of anything else," he spoke aloud his thoughts. "If nothing else comes to your mind easily, don't cook up," said Mr. Girish very clearly. "But I can tell of another positive quality in you. It's your sense of humor, and that's a great one." Possess. Amarnath smiled, but when Mr. Girish asked him to note down a few negative qualities in him, Amarnath smiled with very sheepishly and answered, "Not always focused. How do you bring your mind to focus on stars assigned until completion?" asked Mr. Girish. Thinking for a while, Amarnath replied, "Looking at available resources and planning a way to work out the task and get down to work on the plan, come what may. There you've arrived at the solution yourself," beamed the teacher. "Now plan out the processes step by step." Now here, children, it is said that Amarnath and Mr. Girish are discussing with each other, okay, about the problem what Amarnath was facing during his entrance exam of medicine, okay. Medicine, okay. Now here, Mr. Girish is asking to write down the negative qualities in Amarnath, okay. So he's Amarnath is saying that I am not focused on my negative qualities. Then now Mr. Girish asked him one question, that how do you bring your mind to on focus on a task assigned until completion? Thinking for a while, Amarnath replies that looking at the available resources and planning a way to work out the task and get down to the work on the plan came come what is. Okay, he looks for the available resources and plans for the given task, okay, and work on that plan. And this was the solution for his process to pass the competitive exams. Okay, Mr. Girish is trying to explain our Amarnath here. Okay, now let's read for the children. In the beginning, it wasn't easy at all. Distractions were many, but Amarnath now had a new responsibility. He could not let down his favorite teacher, who had placed so much trust in his capabilities, and so he pursued his goal doggedly, focusing on the vital areas and brushing aside trivial ones. Years rolled over. Dr. Amarnath was well known in the primary health centers in the district as a doctor, always with a smile and one who had enough time to give out to his patients. And when it came to mothers within young children, he was a boon because he could easily keep their children engaged with a box of colors and paper, or give them puzzles to solve. He patiently listened to their narrations about fears and his sense of humor And when it came to the mothers with young children, he was boon because he could easily keep their children engaged with a box of colors and paper, or give them puzzles to solve. He patiently listened to their narrations about their aches and fears, and his sense of humor always kept their spirits up. Now here, children, in the beginning, when Amarnath was working or studying, he was facing some problems. It was very tough for him to solve, but he could not let down his favorite teacher, and the teacher also had trust in his capabilities also, okay, and he was working on it to achieve his goals, that he will pass out his competitive exams and get admissions for the medicines and become a successful doctor in his life. And years passed away. Dr. Amarnath was well known in his primary health centers in district as a doctor, okay, and he had always been there with a smile on his face and one who had enough time to give to his patients. Now even his interesting patients were the mothers with the young children, because they were as a boon for him, because he could easily keep their children engaged with the color box, giving them drawings and papers, or giving them puzzles to play or solve. And he patiently listened to their problems and fears, and with the sense of humor, he always kept their spirits up and solved these problems of his patients. Okay. Now, children, here we have seen that we have to face challenges bravely and we have to find the solution to these problems. Okay, now children, we have seen that Amarnath had a problem that he was lethargic, means lazy to do any hard work, and Mr. Girish was a good friend of Amarnath because he always explained to him how every problem had its own solution. And we learn from the story about the courage, determination and to be focused on our goals. Okay, now children, here we have come to the end of our session. Thank you.